Car Audio Etc is proudly supported by Auto Sound and Security.
Hey guys, how's it going? James here at Car Audio Etc. Behind me, I have a really cool car. It's a 1978 Chrysler Ranger, apparently. But this is technically what's called a Valiant. I knew it was a Valiant, I just realized, read the registration now, and it says it's a Ranger. Not sure what that's about. Some of you guys may know, a lot of you are probably a bit older than me and know more about these cars. But first of all, hey, I'm recording on my digital camera at the moment. I left my GoPro at home this week because I didn't think I'd be using it that much. Kicking back into the legacy stuff next week. And yes, I suppose I should explain. So I know I said in my last video I was going to be doing some legacy stuff this week. If you didn't see my Facebook post, pretty much over the last weekend, I got hit with an absolute ripper of a cold and I was just feeling so shit. And I actually had to take a couple of days off work. I took Monday and Wednesday off work, and I never take sick days because I enjoy my work and I never take sick days. So it was a really, really bad cold. I put a post on Facebook and so many of you guys are really supportive, so thank you to you guys. But if you didn't see that, that's the reason I didn't put any videos up this week. So yeah, that's what's going on. The job in this Chrysler here is done. So it was here from pretty much the beginning of the week. I wasn't really here to do, I could have done it all myself this week, but because I wasn't here, Grant pretty much started it for me. But basically, it's all finished now, so I'm gonna show you what we've done in this, it is so cool, and explain to you parts that we've done, parts the customer has done, and try and give you a demo, how it sounds, because it sounds really good, what specifically I did, what Grant did. And yeah, hope you guys enjoy this video. This camera is so heavy on this tripod compared to my GoPro. You don't realize how light the GoPro is until you're holding up like a digital camera. So, the cool part, straight off the bat, let's just start with the cool part. Now, I need a torch. So, we have built a wall across the back here. Sorry, this camera hasn't got a very wide aperture or lens. But let me try to zoom out a bit. There is a wall that goes all the way from the right hand side here across to the left there. Behind this wall there is a great big huge sealed cavity which goes like, oh, I just realized. Yep, it goes like all the way under the bottom of the ute of the bucket here, underneath there. It's like a whole cavity. I think it's originally where they kept the spare tires in them. But anyway, it's fully sound deadened. We didn't do that, but it was already treated for sound. And I suggested that we build a wall across here with some 6x9s. This camera setup is way harder to use than my GoPro. Okay. So it was my idea to do the 6x9s across the wall and to use the amp that we have chosen. So pretty much my sound system design. But the guy said to me, well, I'm a builder, so I'll just build what you said. So he basically made up this wall himself out of MDF. He fabricated it. I give him a 7 out of 10 for quality of the wall. It fits the hole, but his 6x9 holes were a wee bit. But that's okay, it's working fine. So he built this up and he said, now you guys, because I pitched to him that we would flush mount this amplifier into here. That didn't end up getting done because I wasn't here to do it myself. Grant went for this more half stepped through design with a bit more airflow around it, which is probably in retrospect better for the amp. I always put aesthetics a bit too high up on the priority list, but it looks good. So basically what he got us to do was make the hole for the amp, and then he took it away again to have it carpeted by his upholsterer that's done this whole car, and he got it in the matching carpet as what's already up here, you know. So yeah, it's 4 Alpine SPR69s, Type R 6x9s, and a Rockford Fosgate T400X2AD. It's a 400 watt RMS amp, 200 watts by 2 at 2 ohms, because these speakers are in parallel, one channel each on the 2 channel amp. Coming from RCA's, coming from this up here, this head unit, which is a Pioneer DEH-X9650bt. Actually a really good unit. It's the last one of its kind before they discontinued the 9000 series, and I loved these 9000 series stereos when they were out. I had a 9550 in my car in my Legnum, before they discontinued it, and I got my first doubled in stereo. So yeah, these are a really good stereo. They got a lot of stuff in them for their time. So that was, glare. So that was already in the car when we started working on it. He already had a set of Alpine Type R's. They were in just, you know, simple 6x9 boxes shoved under the hole there. I suggested that we build the wall, we do the amplifier to get them some real grunt. I tidied up all the wiring that was under the dash because it was just an absolute mess. There was wiring hanging down everywhere. Tidied it up, vacuumed it because it was a real mess as well. I gave it a clean. And not only that, I actually also installed some Rockford Fosgate R14X2 4-inch speakers on the top of the dash. We have done this quite a few times now with the classic cars that have up here. It's going to be hard to see, but that little vent up there, that's where the factory speaker sits. And actually, we still have the factory speaker. Or did I just chuck it? So this is the factory 4x6 or something that these cars came in. This speaker here is 30 years old. Rubbish. So we've done it quite a few times with those specific 4-inch speakers mounted up under these grills in some of the old Ford Falcons and the old SS Utes. And it works really well. They sound really nice. They're super clear. They can take a beating for a 4-inch speaker. And all in all, it sounds so good in here. So good. I don't think I'm really expressing very well how deep the cavity behind these 6x9s is. Literally, it would have gone back at least, I'd say, maybe 75 centimeters back. And it kind of goes into a trap as well. It's like triangular, not rectangular. So there's a bit of a sound trap back there as well, which means there's no reverberation. So, yeah, like... sounds so good. I did actually take a picture of the little plate that I made up to mount the speaker on. I'll chuck it up here. That plate was already in the car, which was actually a wee bit rare. These cars often come with no speaker in them, like the factory one is usually gone and there's no mounting plate, which means not many installers know that you can put speakers up there. But we figured it out a while ago. Under the bonnet, nicely built engine. Our power wire just is inside this conduit, comes out of a grommet, which we had to make a hole. We looked around to go through an existing grommet, but they're all tightly packed, so we had to make our own hole and run it through its own grommet. Conduit comes up here, and then the fuse holder is what is this one here. So that one there was already in the car, and we wanted to do something a bit more old-styly, not obvious looking. It's meant to be a sleeper car. So I got another fuse holder from Narva, which is exactly the same as this one. And this 4-gauge here, and coming out here, is the fuse for the amplifier. It's only a 60 amp. And then obviously it comes up, goes to here. And yes, this is 4-gauge wire. So all the wires, we actually didn't do any wire running because the wires had already been run by an auto electrician quite some time ago before this car got upholstered. All the wires are already run underneath the carpet and into the rear cavity, and then the carpet was put down and glued down, so there was no running any new wires, no pulling anything out. We had to use what was run already, and the wire that was in there was this stuff. So it looks like 4-gauge. I mean, it's not a big problem for us because our amp is nice and efficient, but this is not 4-gauge. This is, I would call it 8-gauge. The insulation on this thing, see if I can get it to focus. The insulation is so thick that it's just ridiculous. It's pretty much an 8-gauge wire, which is okay though, because that little 400 watt amp is only 400 watts, only draws absolute maximum of 45 amps. So that is going to be fine. And then what Grant did, because Grant did a lot of the wiring, if I can get a light over here, he soldered a piece of 8-gauge onto it, so it transitions from a 4-gauge to an 8-gauge. And then he also used a piece of thick blue 8-gauge for the remote wire as well, just because it looks cool, you know. So it goes red, black, blue for the power ground and remote wire. And then we've just got, and these are the speaker wires here. Oh god, the light. The speaker wires just come out of there. And then they're like P-clipped and stapled to the back of the wood here, of this whole wall. And they obviously just plug onto the speakers left and right. And then the RCA connections is similar, just that connection on the end there. For tuning it, I use the built-in Rockford Fosgate clean system. Absolute zero clipping. This head unit goes to 61 out of 62 without clipping. And then I was able to tune the gain up to, looks like, around about 49% before distortion happened. So it works really well. What else have we done? We did the 4 inches up there. This is just minor, but there's some wires coming out the back here which run through to the front that he wanted wired up for an earth and for a permanent power supply. That, what that goes to is the customer has a whole great big assembly which goes in here, which actually has sunk in fridges, a big lift up top with mirrors on it, LEDs under the fridges, and nice bar leaner like oak stuff that goes along here. So it's basically a great big bar, and those are the LED supply, that's the power supply for the LEDs. I haven't got any pictures of them, sorry, he did show me, but it looks so cool. So yeah, so I wired that up, tidied up all the wiring, as I said, redid the stereo installation because the wiring for that was pretty average. And yeah, I think that's everything. I'll give you guys a bit of a demo with some different songs. I'm not sure what it's going to sound like in the digital camera. I'm pretty sure this camera kind of just mutes or attenuates when it experiences high volume, but it's super punchy in here. By the way, with the seat, I'm sure some of you guys are thinking, where the hell's the seat? There is a seat just over there. That's not the seat that come out of it though. These Valiants have a great big long bench seat which goes all the way across, you know, from here to here, which at the time we knew it was going to have a bench seat, and we still went with the 6x9s. We thought, you know what, well, the treble will still manage to find its way around. We angled the outer tweeters to the outside and the bottom tweeters angled them up as best as we could. That's the great thing about these Alpine Type R's, you can adjust the angle of the tweeters. But that's the main reason why we did the 4 inches. After I discovered that there was a mounting for a speaker up there, I said it would be a really good idea if we put some 4 inches up there to have some treble at the front, and I definitely think it helps. So I'll give you guys a demo now, and then we'll call that a Friday done, and I'll catch you guys in the next week, when hopefully I will be finally doing some stuff on the Legacy. Not sure how that looks, but let's play some music. I'm gonna play Back in Black by AC/DC just because the start off of this song, the intro, sounds so good on the system. AC/DC, it sounds so good in here. These 6x9s are so punchy, but man, can they go low. I have got a 50 hertz high pass filter across the whole system with the built-in digital high pass filter on the stereo. Only reason I'm doing that is to try and protect the 4-inch speakers a wee bit. If I didn't have them up there, I'd probably have it off, because I can actually notice a bass difference turning it on and off, which means these 6x9s altogether do go lower than 50 hertz. So what I would told him I would like to do is upgrade the stereo to something that has got independent filters or crossovers for the front and rear channels, and that way it high passes the 4 inches at like 100 hertz or 125, and I'd probably put the 6x9s down to 20, because these can go super super low, but 20 hertz is like a good infrasonic filter, you know. But he said he's happy with the stereo, so we're not going to change that, so it's a compromise. We've got a 50 hertz high pass filter on it, which is not limiting like too much bass coming from the back and not super protecting the front speakers, but it is helping a wee bit, I'd say. So there is a compromise going on there. Let's listen to this song.
Yeah, I got a suggestion. Crack it. Thank you.
song sounds so good, I love it. Really good bass coming from these 649s. Don't know if you can hear me, the amp's mildly warm. It's not hot, but it's mildly warm. Oh, I'll play something vocal. The beast in me. This isn't a very upbeat song, but it's very vocal and it sounds great. Is caged by frail and fragile bars. Restless by day and by night, rants and I feel like that song sounds better in my car. I think these 6x9s are just quite vumpy, you know, quite resonant around that bassy voice note, you know. So there's a lot of resonance there. Let's go back, let's find something else. Ooh, this is interesting. Hear that rattling? If I touch the mirror, it goes away. I can hear the metal of the car rattling though, that's interesting. Something that he wanted to be able to do was, you know, open up the doors and listen to some music while he's having a barbecue or while he's having some drinks with some friends. Just evident that you could open up the doors and sit back here, have a beer, have some music playing, and it will come out nice and good. This is a bassy song. Again, I'm not really sure how this is coming through on the digital camera mic, but it sounds so good in here. Those 4-inch prime speakers are so clear for 4-inches. And for prime as well, you know, I've always never been a huge fan of Rockford Fosgate's prime lineup, but those 4-inches are my single most favourite 4-inch speaker that I know. 4-inch coaxle, that is, you know. Not counting, like, you know, a 4-inch standalone component speaker by Vocal or something. But they're my favourite 4-inch coaxle speakers, these prime ones. So good. Play this song and then that'll be the last one. And I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. I wake up every day is a daydream. Bonkers. Yeah, that'll do, guys. I have got the battery on charge, but we better not run it flat. Turn the key off. There she goes. So yeah, that's what I've been having fun with for the last couple of days. Just getting that finished. And yeah, she's all done. Hope you guys have enjoyed this video. Let me know what you think of the system that's in there. Let me know if it sounded any good on camera. I hope it did. I should be back to my GoPro next week and have some better sound for you. Yeah, God, like sometimes I go a week without making a video and I forget how to close it out and what to say. Thank you guys so much for watching today's video. Choose to be happy and I'll catch you next week. Have a good weekend. Ka kite ano. Everybody says that I gotta get a grip, but I let Sunday.